Okay, guys, it's your favorite day. It's my favorite day. It's Dean Ambrose's favorite day because he just won Money in the Bank in the WWE Heavyweight Championship. It's Podcast Monday. Woo!
Also, LeBron's favorite too.
I didn't want to mention it.
So I'm a little salty about that.
I'm a little salty.
Everybody knows salty. So, topics of this week, we're going to talk about the new Yu-Gi-Oh game on the 3DS, the OCG banlist, and several WCQs that happened in Asia and in South America. Then we'll close it off with YCS Origins. But first things first, we'll do it. Oh, he didn't say it, thank goodness.
On the real list.
So, Takahashi Kazuki, the creator of Yu-Gi-Oh, now has an Instagram. He has pretty sick images, like this one of the Feral, the new antagonist of the movie, who I can't remember the name, and my boy. It's just like a cool thing. If you're interested in seeing more of his artwork, follow his Instagram.
This is the manga artist, right?
Yeah, the main creator.
Interesting. Wonder why he's doing this.
Boredom?
Commission? I don't know, but he just put into his mangas.
he doesn't make mangas anymore, I don't think.
No, there's a different team that does handles it. He just does
he supervises
main
at
art.
Point.
Yeah, he supervises there's... the art.
Oh, he doesn't do the other series anymore?
No, he only did OG? Those are separate authors.
Yes. Are they?
Yeah.
So he only did the original.
Yeah.
Wow. So they're pretty much paying him for like the rights of Yu-Gi-Oh, right?
At this point, yeah.
I know that.
He tried to do a one-shot in 2013, but it looked like they got to pick up.
What's a one-shot?
It's the pilot.
Oh, a pilot anime?
No, a pilot manga.
Yeah,
Oh, pilot manga.
He shot out a pilot, and then I guess it didn't grow successful, because I think Shonen Jump typically puts out one-shots sometimes well-known authors, but sometimes they just don't pick up.
I see. So he's just chilling at home, making that money?
Making that movie money, dude.
The movie money?
So
that's cool.
If you're interested, he's on Instagram, Kazuki_Yu-Gi-Oh. Other than that, next topic. Yu-Gi-Oh! Psycho Card Battle. This is posted June 16th under Perfectly Nintendo. So the new 3DS game we mentioned roughly, honestly, beginning of the year, actually. It's gonna be on the 3DS. Oh yeah, so it was announced back in December during the Jump Fiesta. That was fun. So the kicker is this game is free to play.
What? Free to play?
Yeah.
But
there's
you know how free to play models usually are.
Microtransactions?
In-app purchases are available.
It's a phone game?
It's a 3DS game.
How do you download? Oh, the 3DS have that downloading thing now?
Yeah, they have a game store thing.
Oh, that's cool. What's the microtransactions?
We don't know yet. Might be like booster packs, like a Hearthstone thing. Might be singles. That would suck. I don't want to pay $2 for a Blue Eyes.
I feel like if it's like Hearthstone, it might do really well. Where like you can still grind your way to a good deck. But I don't know. People don't like grinding, so it's like that Pokemon thing. How we argued about why Steve got banned. Like I'm not trying to make my deck. I just want to play the game.
I don't think we discussed it on stream yet.
About Steve getting banned?
Yeah.
Yes.
Oh.
Well, he didn't get banned from Yu-Gi-Oh.
He didn't get banned from Yu-Gi-Oh. So, do you want to explain it, or do you, John? Do you want to explain it, or do you want me to do
I'll
it?
I'll give the gist of it. So, Steve had a Pokemon game, but he lost a lot of his data at one point. So when he got a new one, he decided just to use Pokegen to create Pokemon that create viable teams. Because let's be honest, putting effort in the old generations was extremely time consuming. It's monumental waste of time without RNG abuse. And even RNG abuse is annoying to deal with. So Steve just decided to Pokegen. He was in the middle of a tournament. He was doing well until like one opponent decided to whine about something.
He noticed it was wrong.
The judge, No, I mean, that was actually possible. It's just, he was just whining. It's like, oh, you shouldn't have one hit KO'd me. So then the judge took a look at Steve's Pokemon game, and then all his Pokemon were hacked because he didn't gen them properly.
Well, I think he told me it was Pokeball, but if you guys don't know this, but in competitive Pokemon, you have to train your own Pokemon. Like, you don't just get a Pokemon, like, you don't... Not everyone's base, so you have to train your own Pokemon. So what he did was he hacked
like random stats.
Yeah, so he hacked the game so he can have legit Pokemon. They're hacked, but they're still legit stats. So the judge looked at his Pokemon and was like, oh, you didn't train these properly. Like, you didn't literally train these, you hacked it. So he got banned. So, mm-hmm. I mean, in my opinion, he shouldn't have got banned because I'm trying to play the game and I'm trying to train Pokemon. So in the same aspect of this game, I hope that it's not... I'm going to spend like 30 hours just to make my BA deck. I just want to play BAs and I just want to compete already, you know? So that's my argument. So I hope that this game not end up to be.
Some more information regarding this game. The tournament you, the player, are participating is called the Legend Challenge. Looks like the battles will be under the Speed Duel format. We mentioned it a couple months ago where it's similar to DT format. You only hit 3 zones for everything, a 20-card deck. Also, the cards, so it goes up to the latest starter deck will be included when this game was released. And it comes out July 6th in Japan, which is 2 weeks? Yeah, 2 weeks.
Do you know when Gwen's coming to America?
No.
If ever?
No news about America or Euro.
Hmm. I don't think it's ever coming then. There's a lot of games that never come to America.
It's like Duel Carnival came 2 years too late.
Yeah, like the meta is like shifted.
Shifted 6 formats.
So, yeah. Oh, you want Duel Carnival, and then Carnival is like, oh, you guys want Duel Carnival? It's like, not anymore. Jeez, man.
I feel like they're still on snail mail.
I mean, they fired Kojima. They can't make. They possibly can't make any good decisions. Like, I think that's what's going on. Like, their infrastructure's gone to hell.
Isn't there a new game, Pachinko game? For, like, Metal Gear?
Yes.
Metal Gear. Awesome. Alright, is that it for this news?
Yeah, that's it for the 3DS game. We'll see how it does roughly 2 weeks. Next news, OCG banlist!
Yay, so exciting.
It is, because this is actually a meta changer. Let me get the... So, if you didn't know... Okay, so, what is your prediction of what got banned? Starting with John.
I already saw this, so I can't.
Okay,
yeah.
Never mind.
I forgot what it was, but I don't think... Nothing. I think only one card was banned?
Nothing got banned?
Okay, then there's two or three limits.
Nothing got limited.
Or am I looking at the wrong list? Is this the Kieran list?
What?
Where Kieran got limited one?
That's the fake list.
Oh, the fake list? Okay, then I don't know what happened. I think this is a nothing happened list then, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I should
think they brought back something or no? Or nothing?
So limited, nothing got changed. Semi-limited. Wall of Revealing Light over there is now 2. Thousand Night Restrict is now 2. And Sengen is now more free. They gave him the government subsidies, dude. Or... What's the word I'm thinking of? Government support? Like Obamacare?
Welfare?
Yeah, there we go, yeah. They realized they jailed the wrong man. My opinion?
I don't know. I think OCG is a little off.
Like, these aren't really, like, super big, so they're fine at 2.
Did it unlimited anything?
Let's talk about this first, then we'll go to the limits.
Oh, it doesn't matter.
Okay. John, it doesn't matter. Moving on. Unlimited. The only card yet unlimited was Super Rejuvenation. This might be iffy, because Blue Eyes is still full strength there.
Yeah, I was about to say that.
So we have to wait and see what happens. But
was it 0 to 3, or was it 1 to 3?
2 to 3.
2 to 3? So maybe at 2 they didn't do anything, so maybe just brought 3.
Blue Eyes, I don't think you really discard at this point. It's mostly you bring an alternative, you make your 8, or whatever card you need.
Japan hasn't had their, when's this in effect? I'm sorry.
I didn't write it down.
Is it Post Worlds?
Soon, I'm gonna get this website. I got this information from the Yu-Gi-Oh! Org. Shouts to them. August. Oh, sorry.
Yes, Post.
July 1st.
Oh, so pre-Worlds? I guess. Oh. I just hope that it's not after. Not before their nationals, because that would kind of suck.
Thanks for the follow, Princess. Oh, I didn't read fast enough. Princess Twilly Sparkle 7. With that, we hit our 200th follower.
Woo!
Now I have to do a giant tournament.
Yeah.
The prize could be Dead by Daylight on Steam, because I need friends to play with.
Well, yeah, back to the topic. Yeah, I hope it's not before their Nats. Even though it doesn't change anything, but it means that they're not going to have another ban list for a while. So that kind of sucks for them.
I feel like OCG ban lists, there's only like one impactful ban list a year, and then the rest are just throwaways.
Oh yeah, like the Purge. They have the Purge once a year well.
Yeah, and that's pretty much it. Like, I think it varies from effectiveness, but I mean, at least they've been mostly impactful for the past three ban lists. I feel have stronger impact.
Are you going to count the E-ban or no?
Emergency ban, that was still impactful as of...
Yeah, are you going to count that as a change of ban list?
I mean, that added to four impactful ban lists then.
Yeah. The E-ban was actually really impactful. Yeah, I agree with you.
Twilight Sparkle. Okay, I'm sorry. I can't read the breakups.
You can't read it all, guys. So, yeah, I agree with John. They're probably going to have the Purge coming soon to them. Because the last Purge for them was the Dante hit. And the Pendulum hit.
Monarchs.
So, Monarch hit, yeah. That was all one time, right? All three at one hit?
Yeah. And so, they, like, do outlying ban lists.
Yeah, then they'd have then Blue Eyes and Dark Magician became the best deck.
Well, about that, let's go to the next topic. In terms of WCQ Asia, there's, for the most part, they use OCG cards, though. So we got a kind of a preview of what's going to happen next format. Let me get to the event. So this was from the event, yugioh.wordpress.com. Also the same people, I think, with Yu-Gi-Oh! Singapore Edition on Facebook. So the Asian Championship 2016 took place Sunday, 19th, 18 duelists from Asia competed, from Philippines, Hong Kong, Malaysia, Taiwan, Singapore, like that general area, like no China, no Korea from what I saw.
So I think that's Southeast Asia?
Yeah, pretty much Southeast Asia. Yeah.
How many invites are there given?
I think they only get one or two.
Oh, wow.
So they get the sick Dark Magician mat for qualifying. They actually had a giant card event. It was the new Silent Swordsman and Silent Magician cards in the OCG.
No way. That's so hot.
Where's Teemo at, dude?
Oh yeah, the ultis.
Yeah, no, these giant foils. In terms of who won, I only have the second place deck. The first place, the cards aren't on DN yet. He used a new ABC Dragon. XYZ Dragon cards. It's pretty dumb from what I've read.
Is it next set or what?
No, it's the structure deck actually.
Oh, when are we getting the structure deck?
I don't know. It just came out like literally the day before the championship.
Oh wow, this guy breaking the meta.
Asia? I was under Asia.
Do we know how many participants this had?
18.
18 participants?
Yeah.
Is this like the Australia one where you had to win your Nats to go to this?
Yeah, you have to win like the Philippines or like South Korea. Oh, sorry, Hong Kong.
Oh, okay. So this is kind of like their own kind of world, huh?
That's how it's like the equivalent of you winning in England, but then you have to play in the European Nats. I mean, WCQ. Because that's the region.
Okay, I see that.
Or I think it's more like Australia. Because yeah. I think European, you can still go without an invite. Like with the regional invite, you can go with the regional invite.
Well, wait. No, I'm going to talk about from Nats to Worlds. Their Nats is different from their WCQs.
Their nats are different. Yeah, I know. Okay. That's what I meant. Like, you have to actually win your nats to go to this Asia tournament championship.
Yeah.
To go to Worlds.
So, second place, we had a Liu Wenqin from Taiwan playing DDD. Of course, DDD is a lot stronger OCG because they have access to cards such as DD Lamia, DD Copernicus, Newton, and a bunch of other crazy stuff. I'll go through the deck quick, and then we'll do some quick explanation. There's no Sandstorm Darun playing right now.
Is this first place?
Second.
Second place.
First place was the ABC Galaxy build, but the cards aren't available on DN, so I didn't have time to put it on the.
You probably don't even know what they do.
I have a general idea, because the fusion's pretty dumb.
Is it a Towers kind of deck, or is it like...
No, it's more of a, you set your field up.
Oh, okay, so like Unbreakable
Ward. Whatever I want kind of deck.
So you have like a
rank. I'm not even joking.
You make an Infinity, and then their boss monster.
Oh, okay.
That's cool. But their boss monster changes from time to time, because like, there's no set boss monster. There's like, I want to say this deck has no clear focus, but it has a lot of goals it can accomplish to win. Like, it has a lot of win conditions, but not a real focus.
No, oh, okay.
So
that's cool.
It's kind of hard to describe.
The closest I could think of, maybe, like, Performer Pals, like, you set up, you make, like, a 38 to mess them up, or you can make a, like, Utopia Lightning to go for a game, or an Ignister.
Mm-hmm.
The only difference is this deck doesn't set up to OTK. It can, but it doesn't. It generally just doesn't.
Okay, but in terms of DDD, let's go over this quick. 3 Kelper, 3 Copernicus, 1 Newton, triple Abyss King Ragnarok, 1 Orthros, triple Lemia, triple Necro Slime, triple Swirl Slime, triple Maxi, Junk Synchron, triple Dark Contract with the Gate, 1 with the Swamp King, 1 Harpy's Feather Duster, 1 Dark Hole, 1 Monster Reborn, 1 One for One, 1 Mass Change 2, the Solemn Brigade, with this OG Solemn. Vanities. Nice. Dark Contract with the Witch. And 2 Crush Cards. For the side deck, double DD Crow. Triple DD Crow. Triple Ally of Justice Psycho Reader. Triple Ally of Justice Quarantine. Double MST. Double System Down. And a Book of Eclipse. For the extra deck, double Flame King Genghis. King the Ark. 1 Beowulf. 1 Dark Law, 1 Formula Synchron, 1 Hyper Liberian, 1 Gust King Alexander, 1 Hex Blood King Siegfried, 1 Omega, 1 Clearwing, 1 Trish, 1 38, and 1 Duodon King Kali Yuga. So pretty much with this deck, it's pretty stun oriented or setup oriented. You can OTK because they some of these cards such as Beowulf, I believe. No, sorry, not Beowulf. Siegfried, like when you summon it, I'm getting my cards confused. Alexander, here we go. If another DD monster is normal or special summon on your side of the field, while you control this card, you could target 1 level 4 DD from your grave and special summon it. So you can swarm. Side deck is built towards, looks like Blue Eyes, because Quarantine prevents live monster from being special summoned. You get grave removal for hitting targets in the grave from DD Crow and Psycho Reader. System Down, I believe, is for the ABC Dragon, their machines.
What's the 15th card? He's not running
15th card. I didn't see. There was...
Oh, okay.
I think okay, another MST, but, you know.
Okay, so... I have no idea what this deck does. So,
okay, so
first question is, if you were to build this deck, what should you pick up right now? Because it's going to jump
in. Everything's a common, pretty much.
Okay, so there's no card in here that I need to pick up. Like,
in terms of the main deck, everything is either common or rare.
Except for the OCG cards, everything is just common.
Yeah, like I want to pick up right now to get ready for it.
The extra deck though, Kala Yuga's a super. Of course, you have the generic synchros. The Arc is a rare, so it's not really pricey. The only thing that might be like, it's like the actual traps they run, like Strike.
Oh, okay. So all this is like cheap. This would be like the next budget deck, you would say.
It should have been.
I wouldn't call it meta here, though. Because, like, we don't have Harpy's Feather Duster. They have a lot of good combo cards over there compared to what we have.
Yeah, I'm going off what John says. We're supposed to get a DD structure deck this year, but they postponed it to next year. At that point, DD pretty much might be dead.
Yeah, I'm saying like if this deck came out today, right?
Yeah.
You don't think that would be competitive? You don't think it'll be
no,
tier 1?
No, it'll be hella competitive.
Yeah, so I'm
right
saying
now.
Like, yeah. Yeah, I'm just saying like if I were to pick it up today because it's coming out tomorrow, what would I pick up? But you're saying it's all common, so it doesn't matter.
Yeah.
There's no like card that we should look out for, so I'm saying.
Yeah, okay.
Except for that quarantine card, that's if Blue Eyes comes a thing, like that actually might be a hype like a card that might jump the price.
Quarantine?
Yeah.
Yeah.
70 attack, 12 defense, not that bad of a stat.
Yeah, like I mean I might pick some up right now, man.
I don't think Blue Eyes has any monsters to attack over it either.
Quarantine?
Yeah, it's a 17.
Yeah.
It's
oh,
17. I think their highest is like 15.
Oh, that was a hand trap. Never mind. It's a monster you summon?
Yeah, it's like...
Yeah, you summon it, and then they can't special summon light monsters. That's it.
Oh, okay. So it's kind of like a barrier, but stronger.
Yeah.
It's like concealed light against black wings.
Concealed light. Don't talk about that guy. Horror.
So, second place, congrats to him. First place was a... Dennis, you want to say this?
No.
Chou Su Yu, from
sounds
also from
good.
Taiwan, playing Galaxy ABC.
I feel like the H is silent.
I'd have to say sound.
Chou. Chou.
Okay.
I feel like the H is silent, yeah. John's right.
Okay. Congrats to him, he gets first place. We'll see him in Orlando.
Oh, so the card already kind of jumped in price. It's like a $3 super now. When it was like...
Lowest at 30 cents.
Yeah. Let me see. Yeah. It used to be like 30 cents. 40 cents.
Let's take a quick break while I get ready for our next big of topic. So let's talk about our quote-unquote sponsors.
Alright, sponsors. Check us out on TCG Player, eBay, and Amazon. Mostly Amazon, because that's mostly where our sales are right now. It's Project YGO at TCG. Project YGO TCG. At Amazon, yeah, we have the finest product. You can check us out on eBay if you guys want any. If you guys want any anime sleeves, we post a video once a month to show what our new shipment is. So, if you guys are interested, just PM us on Facebook. We ship anywhere in the world, and you will get it fast. Cause if you try to buy anywhere but us, it's probably most likely coming from Japan, and you probably won't get it in like the next 2 weeks. So we ship from America, so you'll probably get it within the week. Sponsors to, I'm forgetting, I'm blanking, Ultra Pro, Ultimate Guard, Monster Binders, I think it's called Monster Binders, right? Monster Deck Boxes?
Yeah.
Finest Deck Boxes?
Ultimate Guard?
Ultimate Guard, I said that one already.
Okay.
I feel like I'm missing one.
Costco.
Oh, Aloe Vera, Crunchyroll.
Costco and Aloe Vera.
Oh, actually, Crunchyroll!
Crunchyroll, they're gonna have...
We're gonna have a type in crunchyroll.com/pstream Project YGO.
So you can
eventually
watch anime such as Boku no Hero Academia or JoJo's.
Oh, it's hype right now. So hype right now. yeah,
JoJo's
gonna
Bizarre
have,
Adventure.
They're gonna have their new summer releases coming up, so you check that out.
Okay.
I just got an email from them. And Citibank, because, you know, they legit.
Waba Bank of America.
Citibank. No, if you didn't know, Citibank replaced American Express at Costco.
Oh, that's right. So, WCQ South America happened also this weekend, June 18th to 19th in Colombia.
Bogota.
Bogota.
So this is South America, right?
Yeah,
this
South
is
America.
Like,
so below
this,
Mexico.
This is Chile.
Yeah,
versus
so
Mexico. 07. You guys get the reference?
This is
Peru too, right?
Yeah, so let me go over this quick though. In terms of how big it was, you had 291 duelists and 11 dragon duelists at the same time. Let me get that the chart for countries. In terms of countries, there's 8 countries participating here. 165 duelists were from Colombia, 40 from Ecuador, 26 from Peru, 21 from Argentina, 18 from Chile, 11 from Venezuela, 8 from Brazil, and 6 from Bolivia. The medal breakdown, though, pretty diverse. We had 64 Burning Abyss / PK Phantom Knights, 53 Mixed Pendulum, and by Mixed Pendulum, it could be like Magic Spectres or just the Draco Pal engine, or as not as ice pendulum. Engine.
As long as the pendulum is called pendulum, right?
Except Klee.
Oh, except Klee, okay.
47 domain monarchs, 44 extra deck monarchs, 44 cosmos, 8 Klee, 8 mermails, 4 cyframes, 4 heroes, 4 infernoids, 3 anti-meta, 2 teller knights, 2 deck I don't want to say, 1 cyber dragon, 1 DDD, 1 deskbot, 1 fluffles, 1 harpies, and 1 yangzing.
The deck that Bui doesn't say because he hates it so much is Eel Swarm.
I have a question. So that DDD player, he's playing without the new stuff.
Yeah.
Is the deck still like pretty good without the new stuff?
It's alright. Like they still have the fusion stuff, which is explosive at times, but overall it's not as it's like 2.5 maybe.
Has a consistent issue or does it have like a power issue?
Power issue.
Power issue still. So the new cards make it go over the top?
Yeah, and also they also increase recycling
the
your contracts.
Just really...
Okay.
Contract
plays are really more explosive when the new cards come out because like you can summon more of a lot of, like different types of monsters.
Okay. Go ahead, continue.
So this is the venue. Nice looking. There's those online timers. The flags.
I think the flags are pretty cool, dude. That's legit as hell.
We can't do that for North American, dude.
Because it would be two flags.
North America, no, California and...
Okay. No, but Canada and...
Canada and
United
North,
States, right?
And USA, yeah. I think it's really cool when they have a North American flag on their shoulder. I think it's really cool. I don't know.
In terms of prizes, we have the same trophies as of, like, South American. So, top 8. So, 8 to 5th, we'll get the yellow trophy. 3rd and 4th, we'll get the green one. 2nd, blue. 1st, red.
This is the same as Central, right?
Yeah.
Do you think it'll be the same for us?
Yeah, most likely.
Oh, okay.
And
that's pretty cool.
In addition to that, if you're participating, you get the Phantom Knights participation mat and sleeves. Pretty sick.
That's what we're getting, right?
Yeah. But if you top, you get this sick Ignister and Friends mat.
Yeah. Is this the same thing that Central America got?
I'm not sure about the mat. They didn't report anything regarding the mat.
Yeah.
But the trophy is definitely.
Trophy
is the same. Yeah, it's the same, but I'm not sure the mat. You're right.
Also,
I think Europe got the same mats, though.
Europe hasn't done it yet.
Europe has done it yet.
They haven't done it yet?
They're after us.
They're after us. They're a week and a half after us.
Edition top 16 gets a Super Copy of Minerva. Super Scarce Championship card and 2 Gold 4 comes out, or Premier Gold 4.
Yo, like, you see on the bottom right corner of the mat, it says promotional item. I really don't like that. They've been doing that often now.
Yeah. Because there's scammers.
I mean, it's still, if you scan
that... It's not hard to take off.
No. That promotional item still stays on the real mat. Like, it still has it on the real mat.
I know, but I'm saying, like, even if they scan it, it's not even that hard to take off.
Yeah.
If they want to watermark stuff, they have to do it better.
But it's not a watermark. It's not meant.
It sort of is a watermark, but it's not even a good watermark.
Because if it's a watermark, it means that when the real mat comes out, it's not there, right? But it is still there. Yeah. So that's not. It's not really a watermark.
So yeah.
So I really don't see the point of it if they're trying to like,
If it's supposed to be a watermark, they're not doing it right.
Because it's supposed to be watermark. You take it off on the real thing.
Yeah.
In terms of Dragon Duelist, second place we have a Christian Xavier Soares. From Ecuador, playing look like Domain Monarchs. First place, John, help me out.
Let me see the name.
It's easy, dude.
Joaquin Petroni?
No, for now.
For Dragon Duelist, right? Alvaro Fernando Soberon.
Where's he from?
From Lima, Peru.
Peru.
He was playing also Domain Monarchs. He got first place. He got the Dragon Trophy. He gets the free trip to Orlando. It's not a free trip to Orlando. He gets to go to Orlando.
It's not free?
I don't know.
I think it's free. It's free first. If you get invites to Worlds, it's free. It's always free.
Okay.
Should be.
Unless he doesn't have his passport, so he can't go.
Congrats to him. He's going to Worlds. Might go to Disney World. In terms of actual top 16... We had, in terms of decks, we had 5 Burning Knights, which is again Burning Abyss, Phantom Knights.
I like that name better than PK Fire, to be honest.
Likewise.
Yeah, okay, it's free. Johnny said it's free, that's sick. 5, I put Mixed Pendulum, because I didn't want to put, I'll type out, like, Magic Spectre or Ignis, like, Dynoster. 1, Tolkien Monarch. 1, Fire King Cosmos. 1, Demizimal Cosmos. 1, Cosmos, and 1, Murmurail.
So, what's the... There's no Brilliant Monarchs?
No. Quick note about this top 16. One of the person wasn't there, so there's a bye for one of the...
Yo, I was gonna ask about that. Why is there a bye?
Like, it says on the pairings, it said bye. So I don't know what happened there.
Yeah, I wonder what happened. Like, did he, like, take a poop?
I think he had to leave?
Oh, maybe. His flight... He didn't think he was on top, so his flight left. I mean, he didn't think it was top, so he booked an early flight.
Mom, I'm in the middle of a tournament!
Yeah.
No, you're coming home right now.
In terms of country, though, we had 5 Ecuadorians, 3 Colombians, 3 Peruvians, 2 Chileans, 1 Argentinian, and 1 Bolivian. Bolivian?
Bolivian.
Was Peru the lowest attendance?
Peru? It wasn't that low. It was like
no, it's Bolivia. 24. Bolivia was the lowest.
Dang, that guy carried his whole flag, man.
So let's go to second place and first place. Second place, John, help me out with the name while I get the deck ready.
So second place, second place?
Yeah.
Yes, he's the
Carlos one. Lopez with Fire King Cosmo.
So
from Colombia.
This is his deck. Somewhat more unique build in terms of Fire Kings. He had 2 Dark Planets. 1 Dark Ellipser, triple Dark Destroyer, 1 Forerunner, 1 Landwalker, triple Slip Rider, 1 Delta Ship, double Dark Lady, double Sword Troopers, 1 Farm Girl, double Strawman, triple Tin Can, 1 Garunix, and 1 Yaksha, and followed by double Maxi. For the spells, double E-Telly, double Allure, double Terraforming, triple Cosmo Town, and 1 Fire King Island. For the traps, triple Call of the Haunted and double Cosmojo. For the side deck, he ran 2 Gamma Seals as well as 1 Radiant, 1 Dark Hole, 1 Raigeki, triple Twin Twisters, double Anti-Spell Fragrance, double Magic Deflectors, and triple Massive Restrict. For the extra deck, number 38, number 107, number 23 Lancelot, Gaia Heart Dragon, Cyber Dragon combo, i.e. Infinity and Nova, Volcasaurus, Pleiades, Windup, Arsenal, Zenmayo, Durendal, Breaksword, Levier, Grand Pulse, Hero Pure Light, and F-Zero. Quick note, I got this from Yu-Gi-Oh! Player Columbia's YouTube channel, shouts to them. They also have for some other top 32 techs. If you want to check out their builds, go to them. One key interesting thing I saw is this is actually a 41 deck.
I don't think that's a problem.
Well, you see more and more Cosmos going more than 40 now.
Yeah, the first thing... First question I have is, this is in South America.
Yeah.
So do they follow America's rulings or do they follow European's rulings?
US rulings.
US rulings? Okay. Because I noticed that a lot more Cosmos are topping in Europe than they are in America. And I just realized because the ruling's different. Like, their Call of Haunted, their destroyers actually, like, activate. You know, where us, we don't. So, like, if you MST call, and you chain the call, Dark Shard comes out. I guess it pops something on the field, whereas if here, we have the ruling where it doesn't have the timing to activate, so it doesn't get to pop a card. So infinitely, like, Cosmo's better in Europe, where Japan and Europe have the same ruling, the correct ruling, I guess, you say quote unquote correct ruling. So yeah.
Other keynotes, he's the only one, like. In terms of Fire King builds, I don't really see a lot of people top with Yaksha. It's pretty sick.
I don't think Fire King Cosmo tops a lot, in my opinion. Yeah.
I feel so like... How many rounds was this tournament?
I believe it was like 9 and then cut top 16.
Oh, it's kind of a lot still. I was saying it was less rounds and I see it topping more in tournaments where it has less rounds because like you can luck your way.
Yeah.
Do like 8 rounds, but like if it's 15 round tournament, I don't think you can luck your way 15 rounds. Not luck, but like you're probably gonna break. You're gonna auto lose some games.
I think that's pretty much it. Yeah.
Yeah. Let me see.
So congrats to him getting second place, but that's not first place.
Does he still get invite to Worlds?
I believe top 2 does.
Yes.
Top 2? I'll confirm.
I only know North American policies.
6. We get top 6.
We get 6.
Yeah,
we'll have like a huge ass country and Canada, pretty much.
So Dennis, you should introduce the first place, because you know about winning.
What do you mean?
I have no idea why I said that.
I know about winning, but thank you, Vui, for sucking my.
Is that
boom.
An insult?
I have no idea.
Is that a, like, inherent insult?
I don't know. Was that passive aggressive or was that just a genuinely compliment? I don't know.
You got your invite. That's all that matters.
Oh, Joaquin Petroni from Argentina.
So he was playing Draco Slayer Performer Palace. I got this from Team Exodus Yu-Gi-Oh. It was in English, but I didn't really pay attention to the explanation. So we'll wing it. Yeah.
Wait, it was in English and you couldn't understand it?
No, I just went through half of it, then I just went back. I just did other stuff.
Okay.
So in terms of the main deck, he ran two Archfiend Eccentric, triple Magical Abductor, one Autorized Pendulum Dragon, double Perform Power Autorized Unicorn, one Perform Power Autorized Light Phoenix, one Skullcrobat Joker, one Monkey Board, one Lizard Draw, one Yeet Turtle, triple Sorcerer, one Luster Pendulum, one Lector Pendulum, two Lectors, triple Masters, two Effect Veilers, two Maxis, triple Unicorn, and two Raccoons. For the spells, triple Terraforming, one Painful Decision, one Draco Faceoff, double MST, a Necro Valley, and double Sky Iris. For the traps, there are no traps. For the side deck, he had triple Ghost Reaper, one Maxi, one Effect Veiler, one Raigeki, one Pendulum Storm, one Storm, two Twin Twisters, one MST, triple Book of Eclipse, and a Royal Decree. For the extra deck, double Abyss Dweller, one Giant Hand, one Diamond Direwolf, one Castell, one Dark Rebellion XYZ Dragon, one Number 38, one 39 Utopia Beyond, one F-Zero, one Dante, two Magisters, one Ignister, and two Dinosters.
So just to reiterate what we said earlier, only first place gets to go to Worlds, not second.
Okay.
Unfortunately, same thing as Central America, just a reminder.
Alright. We see he opt not to play the Autized Fusion version, which includes Vortex Dragon, Meteor Burst, Absolute Zero sometimes.
He's not playing Autized Fusion at all.
I don't know, like, the side deck, I'm not agreeing with all this back row hate, like the Pendulum Storm or Storm stuff. That's a lot of stuff.
What's that card in between Raigeki and Storm?
Pendulum Storm.
What's that card do?
Destroy as many cards in each player's pendulum zone as possible, then target one spell or trap card your opponent controls. And destroy it.
Oh, okay. So it's an MST. It's an MST?
Yeah.
It's more like a D-spell, because it's not quick play, I think.
No. Oh, okay.
It's like Storm, but not as many cards.
Yes.
Wait, it's not real bad. Unless it's like the mirror, I guess.
Yeah, like you have to get rid of scales or... I don't know, this all seems like the clean matchup, because Scout's the dumbest thing ever.
Well, like, I guess, I don't know. He's also playing Lectors in here, so I guess he thought the Pendulum meta is going to be super heavy.
No, no, he won, though, so...
Yeah, so maybe he did play a lot of Pendulums.
Yeah. So I feel like his Cosmo matchup would have been sort of weak.
But I find it odd that he's playing, Odd Ice? That's what it's called, right? Odd Ice Pendulum Dragon? And he's not playing the fusion card, like,
Urban
why not?
Thing 16, I hope I pronounced that right, I pretty much butchered it, I think. Sorry, Dennis?
The Odd Ice Pendulum Dragon, I find it weird that he's playing that and not the fusion.
Well, the problem, like, he also runs, Utopia Beyond. So
is Beyond rank 7?
No, it's a rank 6, but the combo is, you summon Beyond, when Beyond is summoned, XYZ is up in all attack,
oh,
it comes 0.
5,000, right?
Yeah, it's 35k.
Okay, that's fair enough. Who's level 6 beside Kieran? It's just Kieran, right?
A monkey board.
A monkey board 6?
Yeah.
That's interesting.
If you ever get to that situation.
Yeah, but that's a game-winning shot then, I guess. Yeah, 5,000. It happened to me on Dueling Network. Yeah, I mean, it's a pretty good deck. I see this guy still playing Necro Valley. I feel like, what's that one card? Spellcaster Secret Village is better, but I guess he's not playing all Spellcaster, so I guess it's fine for him to play Necro Valley. Necro Valley is interchangeable with Spellcaster Secret Village, but I think Secret Village has a better opening play. Like, if you go Secret Village first turn, it's Monarch, it's kind of GG. So, yeah.
I don't think he fears the Monarch matchup. It doesn't look like. Necro Valley just pretty much for the maybe B matchup. B's
yeah, yeah. I feel like Necro Valley does the same thing as Secret Village does, but Secret Village is better opening card than... Because they both hurt... The Necro Valley hurts BA and a little bit... And a little bit of...
Monarchs
and Cosmo. And Secret Village does a Pendulum, Monarchs, and a little bit of Cosmo.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
I think he's just looking at like the bigger piece, like which matchup he needs it. Like,
yeah,
he's
exactly. Yeah,
expecting what's going to be more.
Yeah. What's up with the Book of Eclipse, though?
Either just stop Pendulum plays or BA.
That's fair enough. Well, why not regular Book of Moon?
Dude, you know how scary PK Fire swarms, dude?
Oh, I guess.
You blink and then your whole field, their whole board is filled with Break Sword, a Levier, and two Dantes.
I guess, yeah. Ah, that's fair enough. Yeah, I can agree with that then. Because then you can Book of Eclipse on the Break Sword pop, and then they just level face down. All right, fair enough, Bowie.
So congrats to him. I think
that might be a hot tech, dude. Okay.
Dude, we're playing the cross format again.
I might be hot tech, dude. I don't know. It's pretty good. So, you go Book of Eclipse end face, and the B-Shirt goes face down, and like they can't do anything during your turn because they can't. Yeah, it's face down. You can't activate. It's pretty hot tech.
Moving on. Oh, actually, let me get a trophy picture quick. Yeah, the trophy picture. There he is.
All right.
Thanks for the follow. Hey, I am Forsaken.
Dang, three follows already?
So yeah, here's his picture. Congrats.
He looks unhappy.
No, he looks excited, dude.
Oh, wrong one. I'm looking at Alvaro.
That's the children, dude. Child.
Yeah, he looks happy. Good for him. Is that the same trophy that the blue one? Or was it red, right?
Yeah, it's red.
Oh, is it the bottom? Maybe he's just holding it.
Yeah.
Like, where we can't see the bottom. That's cool.
Okay, let's go on to our next topic, or our last topic of the day, YCS Origins. I believe this was the last event to qualify if you're from the US.
Yeah, Origins is correct.
So, 629 duelists, 10 rounds, 8 Saturday, 2 Sunday, with a top 32 cut. It was announced pretty last minute, in my opinion. That was streamed. I caught bits of it hitting out. Also, key crazy thing is they had a duel between Pegasus and Joey. Pegasus the sack, he played BA. Against Joey's Red Eyes.
What a dick.
They
Who
had
does that?
School series tournament, but there is nothing reported about it. So either they didn't have enough participants, or they did, but it was pretty small scale. In terms of the Dragon Duelists, on Saturday, they had the Dragon Duels. First place on the left, Nathan Tackett. Second place, Justice Long. Third place, Jaden Davis. And fourth place, Tyler Henson. In terms of Sunday, though, Sunday we had Justice Long taking first place this time, Jaden Davis second, Trofer Davis third, and Tyler Henson taking fourth. The overall champion, though, was Zach Taylor. Where'd he come from? Well, Zach Taylor,
no idea.
Winning it all using his Cosmo deck, defeat Eli Buck. What the heck? This isn't consistent. I have no idea what happened. In terms of Dragon card, we have James Shout.
That's embarrassing, Boo. I thought you checked this beforehand, man. Jesus.
I didn't really check for a Dragon. I only checked the deck more seriously. In terms of Attack of the Giant cards, we had James Chow winning the Lector. I have no idea what the second card is or who won it. Konami postage coverage was relatively weaker this time around.
I think it's quite normal.
No, they usually do both days. They did Generation Tournament top. They did Wednesday, Friday, Saturday was reported. I'm pretty sure they did Thursday one, but it's not there. So first place we had a Grant William playing Zexal. Oh, actually before I finish this though, we have to make a correction from last week. I apologize. When I said Generation Duels, I assumed that they played at the same format, so Zexal versus Zexal. But
yeah, that's what I thought too.
From here, it looks like they played each other. So Zexal versus like GX.
But if we reread it, what do you think? I think it might have been like what we thought it was, but they didn't have enough people, so they just combined everybody.
Yeah, that might be a problem.
Yeah, so I think that might have been the issue where they didn't have enough players, so they just combined everybody. Because I think we read it correctly, where everyone gets separated in each respective tournament series. Because I don't think that's fair if, like, GX plays, like, OG. Like, what the hell? But anyways.
Second place, Ray Tanner with Zexal. Third place, Patrick Kowat with Classic. And fourth place, Jonathan Moore with Arc V, also known as Tales of Champs. Friday's duels, we had first place Edmund Chan with Classic, second place Grant Wilhelm second with Zexal, third place David Wilkinson with Classic, fourth place Joel Wigner with Classic, and then Saturday we had fourth place here Anthony Scalini with Zexal, first place Kyle Benson with Zexal, second place Matthew Parloni with Classic, and third place Alex Mondlak with GX. It does mention here that Kyle, the first place, was using Teller Knights with Shockmaster, which is dumb. It's the reason Shockmaster is banned.
I feel like the only reasons why Classic and Zexal did well is because they had really strong cards, and that's pretty much all you need to know.
Yeah, because they have blowout cards like Red Geki and Heavy Storm, and you know, so
I mean,
Pot of Greed.
Pot of Greed. Like, Makira plus a ton of traps and Pot of Greed, you win the game. Like, you get to draw your whole deck with that.
Yeah, so I'm pretty sure. Power cards, like, you can win out of nowhere, you know?
And then Shockmaster, just, you're not allowed to play. That's pretty much it.
Fun fact, our 5Ds didn't top anything during this.
Yeah, so.
I wonder why.
So, in terms of breakdown, during those 2 days, we had five people from Classic topping, one from GX, one from Arc V, and five from Zexal. In terms of first place, Zexal took it one more than Classic 2-1. Second place, Zexal also took it more over Classic 2-1. In terms of third place, Classic took it over GX 2-1. And there's a three-way tie in fourth with one Classic, one Zexal, and one Arc V.
So the guy with the GX mat, that's the only one in existence, right?
At this point, yes.
Yeah, it's like stupid expensive.
I mean, there's those hidden ones.
The judges steal?
The judges steal, but those apparently don't exist.
Those so if I rip that one, if I rip that one, there will be no copies in the world.
Don't be a Kaiba. Okay, in terms of public event though, they did it three times. So one was, of course, you have to play it out, four people are randomly selected. Either based on points, the event you chosen. They also did it for whoever got the 5-day pass for the Origins Game Fair, because this wasn't held in a traditional area where like a Staples Centers or a convention center where you just go in, you don't have to pay for parking. You actually have to pay for the convention itself and then the YCS.
It was like going to Anime Expo.
Yeah. 5-day pass was 55 pre-sale, 65 on site. So we
Damn,
have.
But that Minerva's like 500.
I know.
A little plus.
Shinpai Su with the Minerva. From the points playoff, we have Corey Shelley, with the random one, and of course we have here Christian Urena with the 5-day origin pass one. Must be nice.
I was actually surprised by how many players entered the main event.
They need a top, dude.
Oh, I guess that's kind of a lot. 600 for like a tournament where you have to pay to get in, where like there are some tournaments that are like 500 where it was free to get in.
I know,
what the hell?
Nah, dude, if you scrub out, you go to the magic section.
Oh, I guess, yeah. Maybe that's why. Maybe they still had a point to be there beside Yu-Gi-Oh. Yeah.
Quick questions. Always a fun part of these coverage. What deck would win? A lot of my decks. When do we tell them they didn't win?
Where they didn't win. we're from the future. You guys didn't win.
classic support. The burn is pretty hard in this one. It says, Red Eyes Black Dragon, please, and then they put in quotes. I mean, parentheses did. Red Eyes just got a bunch of new support in Clash of Rebellions. This is also a good one. Make Gate Guardian playable.
Actually, that's actually would be really cool if they make Gate Guardian playable.
Yeah, Dark Magicians, keep your eyes out for Dark Illusions, then.
Yep.
What else do we have here? Who to give a structure deck to? A lot of Akisa plant boys.
I wouldn't mind that, dude. She's like probably one of the hottest characters in the game. In the show.
And she's most likely the most legal of them.
So. Yeah, that's
it. We can't, dude. She's Yusei's. And Yusei doesn't want the love. No!
Yeah, but she's like, okay, you don't want me. I'll just be a scientist too.
No, she's a doctor.
Or doctor.
Wait, this really happened in the show?
Yeah.
She confessed to him?
Yeah, I think she did. And then Yusei's like, oh no, she was too afraid to confess. So then, because Yusei wanted to become a scientist like his parents.
Okay.
And then they just ended up separating and then nothing happened.
So that's how the anime ends?
Pretty much.
Not bad.
No, we don't know what happened to Yusei, dude. We don't know everybody but him.
Oh yeah, that's right. Because he becomes a scientist, right? And then he mysteriously disappears.
And the series just ends like that?
Yeah.
And then 5 just came out?
No, Zexal.
Oh, Zexal came out?
The most popular answer for this, though, was Solomoto's Yuki's Grandpa deck. Because we all know that his deck has no pathetic cards.
That's the best answer.
No, but then his deck did come out. It just came out in the Yuki thingy, right? With 5 Exotic Pieces?
That's Yugi's, not his grandpa's.
That's his grandpa's.
No, dude, he also had his own cards, like Dark Magician.
Oh, okay.
I thought the Dark Magician was also his grandpa.
Yeah, I thought the whole deck that he used to in the tournament
the whole deck was supposed to be his
grandpa's.
Yeah, no, he changed it up before he went to Duelist Kingdom because he got Rex by Pegasus the first time.
No, but then the deck that he played against Kaiba when he beat him with Exodia, that was his grandpa's deck, right? Card for card?
Yeah, pretty much.
And then, isn't that the same deck you get in the...
No, that's Duelist Kingdom, because it also has, Dark Magician of Chaos, or...
Oh, in the Exodia deck?
Yeah.
Oh, okay, then never mind.
No, dude, the closest I remember was in the anime, he played, a gambling deck against Joey.
Goddamn.
It was pretty bad.
It's pretty bad.
Second place, Aster Phoenix, D-Heroes, always popular, My Valentine, Heartpiece, Where's Steve At? Oh, the best quote. What a grandpa Moto structure that come with a ripped up blue eyes card!
Your honorary ripped blue eyes card. Just so that you can have your dreams.
I know, right? That'd be pretty cool though, have the alternate art where it's ripped in the middle. That'd be pretty cool.
Okay, so let's go top 32, the main event. So top 32, we had 8 Burning Knights, 5 Cosmos, 4 Brilliant Monarchs, 3 Performer Pal, 3 Apex Avion Pendulums, 2 Extra Deck Monarchs, 2 Tolkien Monarchs, 2 Burning Abyss, 1 Fire King Cosmos, and 1 Magic Spectre. In terms of top 8 breakdown, though, well, BAM!
Cool.
So we had Aaron Furman playing Eugene Davis, then he won. Then he played Vincent Campana, then he won again. He got up to the finals where he got wrecked by Jake Finney, who was in Team Card Guys. I don't know, what else do I say about this website?
Nothing. I didn't know you were bringing it up. You guys want to check out the brackets that happened? I don't actually see it on stream, but I don't know if it's delayed or not.
Oh no, wait!
What are you talking about? Anyways, you guys want to know how the brackets went? We have a website called projectygo.com where you guys check out your favorite players and the tournaments are coming up. We're actually trying to update by Nats. So if you have your favorite player, Jonathan Rosario, you can actually search him up and he'll see how many tops he has and stuff. So yeah.
Jeffrey Michael Alexander Jones.
Yep.
Too bad he got wrecked. So second place, we had... What did I say? Aaron Furman playing Demise Cosmos. I got this deck profile from Team Skypes. So let's go through the deck really quick. Triple Tin Can, 1 Strawman, Double Farm Girl, Double Dark Witch, Triple Slip Rider, 1 Forerunner, Triple Dark Destroyer, 2 E-Tellies, 2 Triple Cosmotown, Triple Call of the Haunted, Card of Demise, I'm just going skipping everywhere, Double Pod Duality, for the Traps, 1 Warning, Triple Strike, Double Chaos Trap Hole, Triple Cosmojo, Triple Call of the Haunted, 2 Oasis of Dragon Souls, and 2 Breakthroughs. Side deck, triple Twin Twister, triple Ghost Reaper, triple Master Strict, triple Magic Deflector, and triple Chaos Hunter. extra deck, we had the Break Sword, the Livier, the Dante, the Grampulse, the Giga Brilliant Corbidge combo set, Vocasaurus, Pleiades, Durendo, Infinity set, Gaia Dragon, 107, 38, and Barbaroid. Quick notes, no Sword Trooper here. He likes playing the multiple farm girls. Previously, he played three, but you can't cut up to one because you can actually optimize having a farm girl with counter traps. So like turn one, you play the farm girls, you set your traps. Your opponent tries to do something, you use all your traps. You're open, farm girl goes off, you win.
Okay, that's actually pretty. I actually didn't understand that until someone did it, until you explained it. I didn't know like you use all your traps and you attack for farming. That makes sense then. So I was like, oh, well, couldn't you just run like the Wicked Witch over the farm girl? Because Wicked Witch is actually like can survive stuff. But this makes sense then. This is second place, boy?
Yeah.
Okay.
He lost due to like some minor misplays throughout the game three from what I saw.
Against Jake Finney?
Yeah.
Okay.
Two dualities, doesn't really need you don't really need the special summon. You just do tin can end phase. But he doesn't want to run three because that'd be too much, like you brick.
Because you can draw. It's good opening it, but like mid game or late game, you don't want to pod dualie when you're trying to like go for a game.
Like I said before, six counter traps. He's hoping to win dice roll.
Yeah. And triple call, double oasis, hoping to win dice rolls.
Yeah, but he does side out most of these counter traps against PK. Like he would side out I believe he said he'll side out the strike going first. Put in the warnings. He doesn't like upstart, so that's why he plays 41 cards.
Okay.
In terms of the side deck though, crazy thing he did with Chaos Hunter, he's playing the mirror match, the opponent summons Dark Destroyer. Dark Destroyer summons self, he changed with Chaos Hunter, summon it.
Yeah.
So then he just like wasted a Dark Destroyer. Ghost Reaper. There are people see the dilemma that it conflicts with Card Demise. Card Demise end phase, when you activate it, you have to discard your hand. But there are situations like he knows that if you do it in respect to BA, he can outgrind them. Or was that the next person? It's just a blowout against BA.
I'm pretty sure if he wins game one, game two, he's most likely going second against BA because BA likes going first. And he signs Ghost Reapers, so like it's still a viable card.
Long story short, he can wait. He can always stall putting the card demise. Wait next turn.
Yeah, or he can like since he's going second, he can card demise into the Ghost Reaper and then Ghost Reaper them because he still has no monsters on board, you know.
Extra deck, he made Infinity four times surprisingly. 38 was cuttable. He played 107 against Raid Raptors or BA with Catacall in response to Satellite Falcon, the 35 towers like monster.
Yeah.
Meet Pleiades six times.
Oh shit.
And Volca twice.
Slipfire's OP.
That BTS was MVP.
Breakthrough skill is MVP.
Like, he needs it to protect Tin Can from going off. That's all you need. Any other thoughts?
I just like Breakthrough skill. It's a good card.
John?
Not really. I mean, Demise Klee. So, I mean not Demise Klee. Demise Cosmo. So it just takes a different kind of approach, slower approach.
I really don't like hard demise right now. It's kind of making decks that shouldn't be decks into decks again. I don't like not tier zero formats.
Okay. But this is in first place. First place, Jake Finney playing Burning Knights, PK Fire, Beat Backpack, whatever you want to call it. It's Burning Abyss. Fun quote. He said, "Can't wait to play Lightsworn at locals now."
I didn't understand that joke.
Minerva.
Because he got a Minerva.
Oh, I guess. Me two of them, but okay.
He chose to play this over like XYZ Monarchs or Cosmo because it's the most consistent. But although it's not as powerful, it can still make moves to outgrind your opponent.
Yeah, that's what everyone's been saying about BA over any other deck.
I should buy it. No. In terms of main deck, he had one Tour Guide, triple Terror Top, one Taka Tomboard, triple Skarm, double Farfar, double Sir, one Barbar, when Calcath, when Rubik, when Rubik, when Aelich, when Graf. Minimal Phantom Knight engine with triple boots, two cloaks, and a gloves. Spells, triple twin twister, two alert, one upstart, one foolish, and reinforcements. Turns of the traps, triple fog blade, a surprise anti-spell fragrance, triple anti-spell, one vanities, and one warning. The side deck, double vanity fiend, two ghost reaper, triple ghost reaper, one max C, one shutout dragon, triple system down, a regeki, double dark hole, and double master restrict. Extra deck, triple Dante, triple Beatrice, one Grampulse, one Dark Rebellion, one F-Zero, one Nightmare Shark, one Levier, two Break Sword, a Virgil, and Super Dante. In terms of quick notes, he wants a third Farfar, but space is tight. He opts to main the Fragrance because Monarch matchup is what he really is the most. And this is the only card that he can afford to put in the main deck that won't hamper the actual overall deck. He also runs the chainable traps because No, wait, that's the other person. Oops.
God damn it, boy.
I mistyped!
You should remember everything. Anyways, I'll just go ahead.
Talk about the shuttle dragon? I'm not sure why.
Because Beatrice. He tosses a Beatrice.
Yeah. Okay. In terms of extra deck, he was interviewed. This is from the Carguys video. Blair asked him why he didn't run a second Dante. He says he really doesn't need it. It comes out sometimes for the mirror match or Monarch, but he oftentimes played without around it, not needing to use the second one. Side deck, Vanities for Cosmos or Mirror going first. Cherries for Mirror. This is a good discussion here at point. A lot of people saying, oh, you should play Flying Sea instead. He opts to play Cherries because he can outgrind them, at least with this deck. He wants one Max C because in terms of going in the mirror match, he would side in triple Reaper and then the Max C. Dragons for the Pendulum matchup or Demise. Regeki Dark Holes for Domain Monarchs. Now, that's pretty much it for notes I have.
Okay, so his statement where he said that Spell Fragrance is the best worst card to put in. You can main Master Strict, right? But then it's saying that Master Strict sucks in every other matchup besides Monarchs. And I do agree Monarchs is your hardest matchup, but my argument is that he could have played double Dark Hole Regeki over this triple Spell Fragrance because they essentially do kind of the same thing. Unless you open Spell Fragrance, I don't see it being that great, but I don't know. Yeah, I think maybe he just thinks that getting through the first turn, Monarch's first turn, is super crucial. Because if you lose a dice roll and Monarch chooses to go first, that Spell Fragrance isn't going to do anything for another four turns, right? Because then you got to set it and then, activate. Yeah, so it's literally not going to do anything. And if they see it in game one when you milled it, they're obviously going to set their spells in game 2 and 3. And that's really bad. So, I don't know.
Maybe he was trying to go for first turn.
He must have won a lot of dice rolls. Yeah,
Because I feel like Dark Hole Regeki is definitely better in those scenarios.
It's a better flex card. It does multiple things. Because if you top deck...
Then again, it's in his side. So then,
he could probably side it. Yeah, maybe. Yeah. What I see is that he sides out the three Fragrance, the Vanities for the Double Mask and Regeki Dark Hole, maybe. That's probably, that's probably it. But, I don't know. I haven't tested the Anti-Spell Fragrance, but when I sided it in against Monarch, it's very bad. Or I'd rather have Master Strict, But, that's my opinion. Because it is your worst matchup, so, And then the Ghost Reaper, I'm not a fan of Ghost Reaper, but maybe that's the way to go now. Due to everyone playing BA again. I really didn't like BA winning the event, and I really didn't like how BA was most represented deck.
Dude.
Because now a lot of people are going to play BA at Nats.
You didn't like it, dude. Monarchs didn't even do a dent, dude.
Yeah, I really don't like that. Because then man, I'm playing all of BA. I don't know.
Now I got invested in BA. Quick note though, this morning I saw it was $12 low. It looks like it's going up slowly.
The Beatrice?
Yeah, no, the Ghost Reaper.
Ghost Reaper? Yeah, it was $12, $15.
Yeah.
it's not, not like 17, I think. I don't know. But, yeah, I feel like VA, the mirror match isn't as fair as, like, Shadal mirror match, where Shadal is like, oh, you gotta, like, sack your windows and stuff. VA mirror match is whoever wins the ice roll, because whoever makes the first Beatrice wins. Because, like, you can make Beatrice, it's over, dude. Like, you're not gonna make another.
Farfa?
Like,
huh? No, Farfa.
Yeah, like, when you, once you, when you make your first Beatrice, your opponent goes, makes the first Dante, you can just Farfa it away and, like, okay.
Where
no
did it go?
Beatrice for you. Yeah, where'd it go? Where did it go? I can't see it. So, like, it's not as fair as, like, Shadal mirror match or Necros mirror match. I feel like VA mirror match right now with Beatrice, it's, like, very unfair. With dice roll. So that's my opinion, though. Yeah, anything else, John? Gooey?
Does anyone have VA stuff, I mean, PK stuff for cheap?
You switch to decks last minute?
John,
I think that's it.
So here's a picture.
I was trying to think of something.
Here's a picture of Jake Finney. Congrats to him. See you at Nats. We'll see most of you at Nats because we're going. Don't forget.
I think, find it funny you're here. This picture, like, I don't wear the card guy shirts.
How the mad only is, picture.
How mad Spoofy, man? Like, you had one job, man. You had one job.
No, Spoofy, no.
I think he wore it day one and maybe it got dirty or something. He spilled a ketchup or something. And, like, he can't wear it day two, but, like, come on, Blair, you can have this guy, you send this guy another shirt, man. You guys would have a backup shirt for like, someone tops. Come on, man.
Oh, also, a small minor note, I found that as of June 16th, Lolly's now on Team Card Guys.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I guess.
I don't know how that happened, but good congrats to him.
I don't know what their contracts, like, how what they get for topping and stuff. So, I mean, if he gets free stuff, why not, you know?
So that's pretty much it for this week's podcast. We might hit a dry spell for a while.
Why?
We just finished mostly all the Nats till US Nats, if I remember correctly.
Oh, but US Nats is like 2 weeks from now, so.
Yeah, that's why we're gonna hit a dry spell.
Oh, okay. Next week is probably gonna be like training day. Training with Bowie.
We'll see. Other than that, any last thoughts overall?
Not really. Check out our projectydo.com. It's like our Wikipedia page. You can find your favorite you can find your favorite players there. Yeah, I'm not on there though. I don't know if Patrick Hoban has a page yet. I think gotta work on that. We're working on the bracket, so you can go all the way back to 2012. I think John's working on it really hard. We're getting all WCQs. It's coming together. The front page is not correct, so we gotta actually complete the front page. You can use the search engine. So you type in YCS, what is this? Origins. So you type YCS Origins. You go to that page that we was at earlier, and it shows you all the brackets, the trivia, and players that were, where the event was at, who won, and yeah.
I think someone needs to update the search for function because it doesn't seem to be working correctly.
No, I think it works. Let me check right now.
If you want to buy Burning Abyss stuff, visit up Project Guagio with TCG Player, eBay, Project Guagio TCG on Amazon.
Yeah, I think Bui's gonna get on that right now.
Johnny, last thoughts, words?
Have fun with the new website. Or not new, I guess, but you know.
Okay. Yeah. See you guys.
It's coming together. Okay, bye, guys.
Later.